many of you guys know, I have been a firefighter for over 2 years. One thing I'm guessing none of you have ever seen is how a firefighter puts on turnout gear, with the exception of Jason and maybe Matthew. Today I'll be demonstrating how to don or put on turnout gear for the three different types of calls we wear it to, and then I will also be demonstrating how to doff or take it off. First, you start with your boots. First, you take off whatever shoes you have on, slip into your boots, pull your pants up, put your suspenders on, button, Velcro, and clip your pants. I will now demonstrate. Put your helmet on. You want to make sure your strap is tight against your chin and the clip in the back is tight to where it will sit on your head. You will now put your gloves on. At this point, you would be ready to go on a brush fire. Next, I will show what you will wear for an accident. You will take your gloves off, put your jacket on, put your gloves back on. You are ready to go. If you will be on the ambulance for this accident, you will not be putting these gloves on. You would be putting medical gloves on. I will now demonstrate what you would wear during a structure fire. Your first step is to take your gloves off. Take your helmet off. Loosen the strap. Loosen the back clip. And take your coat off. For girls that are going into structure fires, it is very important that your hair is at the back under your straps. This will keep it from not slipping out during the fire and getting burned. Next step would be putting your hood on. The purpose of a hood is to keep your neck and your hair and your head from not getting burned while inside the structure. Next, put your coat on. Once your coat is fully Velcroed, you will take your hood and wrap it around your collar. This will make it easier when you're putting your mask on. The next step is to get your packs and your helmet. I will be demonstrating how you hook up your oxygen tank to your mask before I put it on. The easiest way to also put your mask on is to flip the back straps over the face piece, and I will demonstrate why it's easier later. This piece right here is what we connect to our face, or our face mask, when we connect to oxygen. The red dial goes up on the face mask and you turn it 90 degrees to the left until you hear it click. Now you would be ready to go on oxygen. To turn an oxygen pack on, you push this red button in, or black button in, and turn it forward until you hear that noise. Keep turning it forward until it stops.
will put it on. The first step is to tighten the shoulder straps. This will keep it on your back the whole time that you have it on. Then tighten the waist straps. You want these as tight as you can get them. You will then have your next option. You can put your mask on, then your helmet on, connect to your oxygen, and then put your glove on. Or you can put your mask on, put one glove on, put your helmet on, connect to oxygen, and then put your last glove on. It all depends on what is easiest for you. I will now demonstrate what I just explained. That is how you put all your turnout gear on if you're going into a structure fire. I will now demonstrate how to doff or take off your turnout gear. First step is to loosen up the waist straps. Unclip it and let them go. You now want to bend over so your pack doesn't fall off as you loosen the shoulder straps. You also want to turn it off. To turn it off, you press the black button in and turn it back towards you. You will then bleed all the oxygen. Until the little dial goes all the way to red and the button right here is not green anymore. You will then hit the yellow button twice until you hear that noise, and then it's completely turned off. You will then take your coat off. Take your hood off, and then your pants. You want to make sure your pants get over your boots, as this is the easiest way to put them back on when you're going to your next fire. You will also put your shoes back on. Make sure your gear gets put back into your rack. The way that I just demonstrated is my personal way of putting it on. There are many ways that people put it on, but it doesn't matter as long as it gets put on correctly.